नमस्ते, लेट अस मूव टू द नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम. दिस इज अपीयर्ड इन द क्वेश्चन पेपर. सी द समराइज्ड बैलेंस शीट ऑफ अल्फा लिमिटेड एज ऑन 31 मार्च 2016. सो 31 मार्च 2016 दे हैव गिवन द प्रेजेंट कंडीशन. देर इज क्यूमुलेटिव प्रेफरेंस शेड्स. ओके, 5,000 इक्विटी शेड्स ऑफ ₹100 इच 60 पेड अप. दैट मीन्स वॉट? This is not fully paid. Okay, only 60 paid up. So 5,000 equity shares are there. Another set of equity shares, 5,000 equity shares of ₹100 each, 50 paid up. So there are two sets of equity shares are there of 100 each, right? So total 10,000 equity shares of ₹100 each is there. One set 60 paid up, next set 50 paid up. Debentures, creditors, overdraft, trade creditors. Here, creditors, you see, this is preferential creditors. So bank overdraft is given separately. So bank overdraft is not included here, right? So we have to treat it separately. Then assets, they have given profit and loss account, credit balance is there. That means loss. Okay, it doesn't matter. We'll see one by one. Okay, they have given the adjustments. Preference dividend is in arrears for 2 years. So there is 2 years. Preference dividend, we have to make the payment. As per articles, it is payable in the event of company's winding up. So as we are winding up the company, closing down the company, we have to make the payment. By 31st March 2016, the assets realized. Okay, these are the assets realized. So we have to take this value, not the book value. Okay, realized value we have to take. Expenses of liquidation, they have given. The remuneration to the liquidator is 3% of the amounts realized from the assets. So all the assets realized, whatever is there, 3% we have to pay. 2% of the amount paid to unsecured creditors. So unsecured creditors, 2%. Here general unsecured creditors they have given. That means what? It includes unsecured creditors as well as preferential creditors. Because preferential creditors are always a part of unsecured creditors. Then income tax payable on liquidation. So when income tax is payable, so it is considered as preferential payment. Okay, so we have to add it to the preferential payments. Then assuming that the final payments are made on 31st August 2016. So this you should remember. Okay, the payment is made on 31st August 2016. Prepare a liquidator's final statement of account. So the first thing what we are supposed to do is, see here, Alpha Limited, liquidator's final statement you are preparing. The first thing, all the assets realized, building, stock, machinery, book debts. So you are writing here, this is the first one, correct? After that, liquidators remuneration, liquidation expenses. So liquidation expenses directly they have given, you can write. Then liquidators remuneration, this calculation we have to make. So you can calculate it separately in the working note and you can write directly here. Okay, so how did we calculate this? They said 3% on the assets realized. What is the total assets realized? 30,50,000. Okay, 30,50,000 into 3 by 100, 91,500. This we got. Then 2% on preferential creditors. So I told you tax payment. Okay, that becomes our preferential payment. So we have to add it to the preferential creditors. What is the preferential creditors given in the problem? 1,05,000, correct? We have to give. See here, preferential creditors is separate and bank overdraft. Other than preferential creditors, that is bank overdraft and trade creditors, this is considered as unsecured creditors. Here income tax is there, no? This is preferential creditors. So here, preferential creditors, 1,05,000 plus taxation, 44,000. On this, 2% we are calculating. So this we calculated. The next one is 2% on unsecured creditors. What is unsecured creditors? Here you can get a hint. You need not calculate how much cash is available for unsecured creditors because we are making the payment to all. Okay, and here there is unpaid amount is there. We can make the notional calls. So usually we have sufficient amount. If you want, you can calculate also, because here you see 30,50,000 is there, right? And whatever we are making the payment is very less comparatively. So unsecured creditors payment, I told you bank overdraft and trade creditors becomes unsecured creditors. So total of this into 2%. So 20,900 you got. So all the three you have to add 1,15,390. Clear? So this you calculated. Liquidators remuneration. Then preferential creditors. What is preferential creditors? You know, here we have already calculated, no? Preferential creditors plus taxation. That we have to give them back the amount. Clear? So we are going to give their amount back. Here we calculated for the purpose of liquidators remuneration. How much commission he should get for that reason. Okay. Here we are paying out. Here we are making all the payments. So we are paying back the preferential creditors, all the dues. Then debentures. What is debenture value? 4 lakh. It is given in the problem. And they said the payment is made on 31st August. So the balance sheet, whatever is given the information is 31st March. Okay. So 31st March to 31st August or 1st April to 31st August. How many months? 5 months. Right. So we have to calculate the outstanding interest for debentures. What is the value? Debentures 4 lakh. Here you see 4 lakh into 15% into how many months? 5 months. 5 by 12. So we got 25,000. So we have to give the debenture holders both debenture value as well as interest. Total is 4,25,000. Clear? Then unsecured creditors. Here we have already calculated. So unsecured creditors. Right? So we have to give them back. Then next comes preference dividend. So preference dividend for 2 years. What is the preference share capital? See, 12%, right? So 10 lakh into 12%, that is per annum into 2 years. So we got here 2,40,000. Then preference share capital, again we have to give share capital back, right? So this much we are making all the payments, right? After that, see, there are unpaid shares, right? So we have to settle it. Now after making the payments to preference shareholders, then finally who should get the capital? Equity shareholders, right? We'll see. So now we have to pay to equity shareholders. Calculation of amount to be collected from or paid to equity shareholders. Why this is given, collected from or paid to? Because the calls are not, the shares are not fully paid, right? So whether we have to get back the capital or we have to give them, we don't know. We should see that. We'll see. Now how to pay the preference equity shareholders? So cash available. How much cash available with us after making the payment to all? So total receipt 30,50,000 minus all the payments. See, payment side you see. All the payments, see, from this 30,50,000 we have cash. From this all the payments we have to deduct. Yeah, show the calculation. So you get 21,110. This is the cash available. Now we have to add notional calls on partly paid up shares. Now how many shares are there? I told you there are two sets of shares. 5,000 equity shares of rupees 40. Right. And another 5,000 equity shares of rupees 50. What is this 40? Unpaid amount. So 100, they are paid only 60 rupees. So 40 is pending. So we are calling it back. Right. So we are calling again 2 lakh back. So they have to pay us. Again, these shareholders, because they paid only 50 rupees, again they have to pay the 50. Okay, now we have already have 21,110 cash. So total amount available with us is 4,71,110. What is the total equity share capital? 5,000 equity shares of rupees 100 each, 5 lakh. Second set, 5,000 equity shares of rupees 100 each, 5 lakh. So total amount to be paid to equity shareholders, how much? 10 lakh. Okay. Now what happens? There is deficit. Clear? So while closing down the company, we have only 4,71,110 to be given to the equity shareholders. But actually they should be given 10 lakh. That means there is a loss of 5,28,890. This should be borne by the equity shareholders. Now how to distribute the loss? So you have to find out deficiency per equity share. How to find out deficiency? So total loss is 5,28,890 divided by total number of equity shares. So this is 10,000, okay? This should be 10,000. So total number of equity shares, 10,000 shares. So for one equity share of rupees 100 each, face value is 100. What should be the deficiency? When you are dividing this, you'll get 52.889. That means 100 rupees equity share has a loss of 52.889. This should be sacrificed by the equity shareholders. Now we'll see amount to be collected or paid. The first set, amount paid up per share. So first set of shares, how much amount is paid? 100 rupees equity share, 60 rupees paid up. What is the deficiency? What is the loss they have to sacrifice? 52 rupees. That means they have already paid us 60 rupees. The loss is 52. So 7 rupees we have to refund. We have to give them back. Correct? Amount to be refunded, 7.111. So second set of equity shares. What is the amount paid up per share? 50 rupees. They have made the payment of only 50. What is the loss actually? Loss for both the parties, it is same, right? 52.889. That means what? 52 rupees loss they have to borne. So they have paid only 50 rupees. So amount to be collected, 2.889. Here, equity shareholders should give the company 2 rupees. Here, the company will give the excess 7 rupees to the equity shareholders. Clear? So amount to be refunded, 7.111. On how many equity shares? 5,000 equity shares. Right? So this is a payment, amount to be collected. This is a receipt. So we have to write the same thing. So on the receipt, call proceeds, 5,000 shares, 2.889. So this we have to write last. And here, amount payment that we have to pay them back, 5,000 shares, 7.111. Here if you are getting decimal points, that's fine. No problem. Okay, small changes, it's okay. Right? I hope you understood this problem. Thank you.